Hi! Welcome to our little interview session with our launch provider, Degauss SRL from Rome, Italy. For that purpose, let me introduce you to Chantal Cavalletti, the CEO of Degauss SRL. She is now phoning us via Skype from Brazil, and she will explain you far more better than me what's going on with our PocketQube satellite RAN from their point of view. Isn't it, Chantal?
Okay.
Yeah, okay. Then if everything is okay and you feel comfortable, then should we start?
Yes.
Okay. Then I would ask you as a first question, could you please explain our pledgers? What is exactly the Gauss SRL team? And maybe you could also introduce yourself.
Okay. So I'm Chantal Cappelletti, I'm a PhD in aerospace engineering. I am the CEO of the Gauss company. Gauss is a small team of 10 people, 10 young people, that decided last year to open a small company. Our idea is to carry on the more than 10 years old tradition of our aerospace engineering school in Rome, in particular in the field of microsatellite. As a school, we have gained the experience of six differently shaped and sized satellite launch. Our main goal is to support a small research group and university to achieve the space using our platforms. Our team is working with several partners in Russia, Spain, US, Japan, Brazil, and now we are trying to involve also people from Uganda. We like to call us more than a business company. We are like a research team involved in several projects, from small satellites to space debris and also biomedical research in space.
Okay, Chantal, thank you for this little and precise introduction. I am not only with Chantal here online via Skype, but also with Paradi Testani. He's actually located at the Moat University, and he's actually the constructor of the so-called Mr. Ford. So, Parit, can you introduce yourself?
So, my name is Paride Testani. I'm the principal investigator for Unistat 5 project of Gauss team. I am the leader of the AAT team, who is currently completing the last operations on Unistat 5. I'm involved in the assembly and integration process, payload handling, and also all the test procedures for Unistat 5. Among payloads, RAN is one of the three pocket cubes we are going to integrate inside next fall, and we are proud to be part of this mission.
Okay, Perry, thank you for this good introduction about yourself. So let's go back to Chantal now. Chantal,
yeah.
Can you tell our pledgers what role exactly does your team play in our mission, the VREN PocketQube mission?
Okay, in the VREN mission, our team will be the launcher provider. Our spacecraft, Unistat 5, will work like a mothership for the smaller VREN pocket cube. We will take care of the satellite as a small baby inside our satellite, Unistat 5. And inside this big ship, really is not too big because it's 50 centimeter cube. Inside this, we will carry on several satellites, and one of these will be the smaller VREN. Really, VREN is the smallest one inside our satellite, and I think it's also one of the smaller never launched.
So, can you also tell us what it's all about with this curious device, MR-FOD?
The VREN satellite will be bored inside the Unistat 5 using Mr. FOD.
Generally speaking, when you deal with a very small spacecraft unit, as a pocket cube or as a CubeSat, The interface with the launcher is generally performed with a specific deployer, which is simply a sort of box from where they can be ejected in orbit, and which also is the interface with the launcher itself.
And we see a good deploy.
We are seeing beautiful view. Thank you very much. That's fantastic.
Actually, it's a very simple device. It's just an aluminum case with an opening door connected to an active mechanism to perform the opening. And after the door opening, a compression spring just ejects outward with a predetermined velocity the small spacecraft inside. In Vran's case, dealing with such a small spacecraft, together with the Moret State University and especially Professor Twiggs, developed the MR FOD, as you call it, that we used to call Mr. FOD, which is the acronym of Moret Rome Femtosatellite Orbital Deployer, which is a very, very, very small deployer, very small aluminium case that we want to install inside Unisat 5. So the reason why we need a deployer is that there is no simply way to make an interface with such a small CubeSat with a rocket. So all the, not only for protection, but also for orbital injection control, we need it, and we need to use it.
Thank you, Parit, for this wonderful explanation about the device MR-FOD. Our satellite will be bring into your custody in less than a month. Chantal, can you explain our pledges, the different steps that our satellite will occur till it will be orbited in reality?
Okay, in October, the people from Uran mission will come to Rome to do the integration in our facilities. The Vran satellite will be integrated inside the Unisat 5, in particular will be integrated inside the release mechanism called Mr. FOD. After the integration of Vran satellite, we will perform some functional tests and additional tests to verify that the satellite light is ready for the launch. In the first day of November, our team, Gauss team, will bring Unisat 5 and his baby Vran in Yasny to in the Cosmotrans launch base. And in this facility, we will integrate the Unisat 5 satellite and also Vran inside the launcher, the Dnieper launcher. On the 21st of November, both of them will be launched in space. The Unisat 5 will be released directly from the Dnieper fairing, and after 10 minutes we will release with a thermal cut system the Vran satellite, so Vran will be free in orbit.
Yeah, and let me ask another question. The orbiting process will take about 1 month. Can you explain why does it take 1 month?
We need this month only to be sure that we are able to acquire our satellite. There are no problems for everything. So really, the satellite will be released before this period, and it could be possible that the people from Vran mission can receive already the satellite before this month. But we just ask to have 1 month to have more, so to be sure that we are able to perform all the mission. Of course, there are the possibility to receive also 1 week later the launch, also the fifth day. But the problem is that during the release of this satellite, we will be not the only satellite released from the Dnieper, but in this mission there are more than 30 satellites. So really it's the mission with more satellite release in orbit. That means that in the fifth period will be very difficult to find, to distinguish your satellite from the other one. So we just take this time to for a safe mode approach.
Yes, indeed. For safety reasons, this is an important matter to do. Also to you, Chantal, thank you for having accepted to make this interview with us. Yeah, what can I say? It was a really interesting time, these few minutes. I would have wished to have more time with you, but we will see us again then at the integration.
Thank you very much to you and see you at launch.
Yes, thank you. Bye bye.
Ciao, ciao.